Hi everybody, we are in Glencoe today again, more precise it's the Arnochtorp West Face, which we can see in front of us, and today we are going up the dinner time buttress as a scramble grade 1, and the way down is via the rheolite rump, which is basically on the side, and we can find the path, and we will pass in the Ocean Cave, I think it's called as well. So should be an interesting and short day. And here we can see nicely the dinner time buttress, how it goes up. And according to the description, we are just following here the path and both the lowest waterfall, we cross over and then just go up. And here we can see nicely, like the Arnochtorp, and Glencoe village. Am Breitnir or something it's called. There's some nice scramble routes as well. And we are now at the first green bit of three sections, which the dinner time buttress has. And it's like, we did 370 altitude meters and we took 48 minutes to here. So definitely not the quickest today. Yeah, it's not really this much to say about it. It is more like a steep ski pass with every so often some steps in it. But the views are quite great, I think. Giant spider. And something to snack. So I guess we get a different pass to leave it. Yeah, so I don't want to destroy the net. Whoop. Yeah. So probably not as busy as I thought it would be here. And we will head basically now up to this bit here in the middle, which looks nice and blocky. According to the book and map, when I interpreted right, it said you should rather go to the right, not in the center, but center looks good to me from here. But we have a closer look. And here you can see how the path goes into here, I think. And we are heading now over here and go just here up. Yeah, as you could see, I had some difficulties, so I went rather in the middle, and over here we can even see some hopes for probably abseiling in winter also, not sure. And now this is how it looks in front of us. Yeah, but as mentioned earlier, usually the path, it goes a zigzag path when you follow it, it goes right around. so not in the middle, because this felt to me for sure more than a one. But again, it's so difficult to judge any grades. I have no idea. I just say basically what the book says, what the grades are. Some are easier, some are more difficult. And we are for sure on the right path. Like again, everywhere crampon marks. Heavy breeze. But the views are so outstanding. So I just had a look at the book, and it actually says that here, this one out here is the easiest one. So this is a dinner time buttress to the left out, and actually the slot we went up, or the gully, that was apparently the right way. So I can definitely say that it feels to me more than a great one. I mean, I had it on the helmet, the camera. I wanted to go somewhere else up, but it was, couldn't do it, too steep. So I just went around the corner and saw it, and I saw it the natural way where the path was actually to the right hand. So I'll just follow up now, as it is recommended, I'm not sure. And then we have a look. And the other thing is, which I haven't seen yet, and we should have passed it to our left, or right now your right, is a rhyolite ramp, which is just basically walking cross on ledges. The Anachdo best face. Haven't seen it at all, which is kind of annoying, because the plan was that we go this one, and then the last bit of the dinner time buttress just down to the car. So I'm not sure if we find the entrance, or I just go here down and have a look and do it another time. Naja. Reaching the top of Anachdo via the west face. Or better, via the dinner time buttress. Was a good wee scramble. I thought personally that it was more than a run, particular in the goody type of thing. The rest was really easy, like steep grass at the beginning, then some squee, rock bends and grass, and then some rock. The rock was really good. And yeah, that was it. And altogether, it was like 800 altitude meters we did. I will make short now a rest, have a look at the map, and then we head down and switch you back on when we find the rhyolite romp, or hopefully we'll find it. And see you later. So we are now back at the car. It was not at all successful. I climbed a wee bit down, had a look, I had no idea where to go, and then I decided I just go the main path, or the tourist path down, which goes up to Bidim Nambin. Then I walk around and follow basically the ledge from the cave. So I have a pretty good idea for next time, for the next adventure when we will do it. And hey, leave me a thumbs up or a comment and see you next time. Bye.